All right, okay, so on the continuance of discussing the resonance travel back planet to planet, okay, and then the spaceship in the middle, okay. Now, in the presumption of the craft is, it has the ability and the skill to mimic a resonance loud enough of the planet that it is going to, all right. Let's say it has the mimicker on board that resonates to the magnetic pull moment. Okay, so let's say the magnetic of the planet is at 330. And there is a point in time where an object is near, another magnet object is near that planet, okay, and it gets pulled in. There is a point in time. Okay, so that point in time, let's say it's at, what did I say, 330, let's say it's at about 360 or something. When this magnet object is at 360 out here in space, it gets automatically pulled into the planet. All right. So, that's great to know. So let's say now you're way over here. You're not at that numeration. So you need some kind of booster mimicker. A booster mimicker. So you're at the 360 point in the mind's eye of the planet. So you're that same almost equidistance of that earlier one that I said, even though you're way out there. You have to be that same power, that same power pool. For the same power pool, let's say, well, instead of 360, you're going to have to be bulked up to 10,000 or something. So you're going to have to rearrange your resonance, your magnetic resonance recognition, to be at that point. So the planet thinks. I'll say the planet thinks. So the planet thinks that you are that one that is at that 360 that it always just snugs in. You know, you're in my field. You're in my field of magnetica, and it's always, that's easy. That is not the problem. You see? So that's free space travel. That's free. So if you can mimic that little, we'll call it asteroidal, meteor, if you can mimic it, you know, when you're way out there, way out, mimic it, even if it is exposing yourself as a strength of 10,000 or 100,000. Okay, now the drama is and the danger is with this direction. The drama is if you do it incorrectly. Do you, let's go with the query, and you already know the answer after. Do you have the possibility on a matching basis to a matching basis to actually pull the originator planet toward you? I mean, the planet you were trying to travel to. You know, do you have that capability on board your little spaceship to actually take this planet out of its orbit based upon your magnetic hold? Do you understand? So when you're talking about the magnetic, well, it's going to be a magnetic resonance throw. You know, it's going to be a magnetic resonance of equipage and knowledge, ability, that you're giving out freely on your little ship. And that ship will deliver you right, left, up or down, and send you off, you know. So yeah, I know it's easy to throw yourself back into the magnetics, like the Maglev train or whatever. You know, there's a magnet up there, and so it goes zooped into the next magnet, and it goes zooped into the next magnet. You know, I know that that's a simple, you know, cheat way, but I was trying to not make it like the Maglev train. I was trying to make it a more excitable, where it actually has that disguise factor. It has that disguise factor of being able to be right there at that, like, that 360 point and the 330 point, you know, where it just goes zooped in. Or no, that was the planet the other way, where it goes that way. So yeah, so the drama with all of this is we have to keep the planet in place and not hurt it and not get that to move out of its orbit. You know, once we have this type of capability and skill, you know, it's an emulation. It's an emulation play that you are emitting out from your ship, a resonance tone, a resonance factor. So you're trying to give all of those exactations of a magnetic pool. I know. Drama. I didn't want magnet only. I wanted to use other things, but. I don't know. I mean, magnets are in a lot of different minerals, a lot of different rocks out there. You know, we don't have to just use magnetites and those types of styles as are obvious. You know, I don't know. I just this is where I'm at right now with it. Is just, yeah, we can go to a level where we upset the planetary balance, and one little ship, based upon its capability of disguise, it can actually literally pull another planet out of orbit. So yeah, so we're dealing with the disguise factor. And the generation, yeah, of course we have to generate that particular resonance, you know, that resonance generators, I imagine, will be, and the speed factor also comes into play. I mean, you'll be able to gain yourself in faster travel. You know, you go back to that immediate magnets. You know, there's that point when the two are, you know, separated, and you touch two magnets together, and it just falls. It just throws itself at it. You know, just it's that point where it just gets so speedy. When it gets that speedy, you're like, oh my gosh. You know. Yeah, that's like a warp or something, a warp factor or something ridiculous, like in Star Trek, but in reality. You know, back to that, it's just the free ride event, the free ride of space travel. Okay, so yeah, I imagine the work in the future will be on resonance generators. Generate your resonance, and you will travel.